Assalamu alaikum, dear brothers and sisters. May the peace and mercy of Allah Subhan Wah Taala shower upon all of you. Welcome to our channel Taqwa. Awoozu billahi Minash Shaytwanirrajeem, BismILLAHir, Rahmanir. Like all other videos, today I'm going to talk about another scientific aspect of the Holy Quran that has been theorized by the modern science very recently. The theory of Big Bang is one of the most widely accepted phenomena that explain the creation of the universe. It is also supported by the scientists and the astrophysicists based on the observational and experimental data that are being researched and recorded for a very long time. According to the Big Bang theory, the entire universe was initially joined together as a single entity, which is called the Primary Nebula. It is also believed that the Primary Nebula was something that had almost an infinite mass with almost a zero volume. That means the entire universe was there within a single dot. Then the big explosion happened, and the universe first came into its complex existence that resulted in the formation of the galaxies and the stars and the planets, the sun and the moon and whatnot. And since then, the universe has been expanding till today. Now let's see what the Quran says on this topic. Do the disbelievers not realize that the heavens and the earth were once one mass? Then we split them apart, and we created every living thing from water. Will they not then believe? Here one confusion may arise regarding the word heavens in this verse. According to the Quranic Arabic, heavens, which means samawat, does not mean paradise, which is Jannah. It means the universe excluding the earth. That means the sun, the moon, Jupiter, Neptune, Pluto, all other planets, every single thing in the universe except the earth is part of the heavens. That means the part of the Samawat. Now, this striking similarity between the Quranic verse and the Big Bang theory is something really interesting to me. It really amazed me that how could a book that appeared in the deserts of the Arab 1400 years ago contain such a modern scientific theory. May Allah have mercy upon all of us and help us understand the Quran and its message more clearly. If you like this video, please hit the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the notifications of our future videos. And if you have already subscribed, thank you so much for being with us. See you next week, inshallah, with another brand new topic. Till then, take care and stay safe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.